Hey guys, I'm recording pandas series and this is very first pandas lecture, so let's begin. Let me open my terminal and navigate to desktop, and inside that I have AI folder, and let me open my Jupyter notebook because I'm going to code everything on these Jupyter notebooks and I will share those on my GitHub. Alright, pandas. And then notebooks. Alright, so what pandas is? Pandas is basically a software library. You can say it's a module written for Python programming languages for data manipulation and analysis. In particular, it offers data structures and operation for manipulating numerical tables and time series. So this free software release under a 3-clause BSD license. So let's begin. Initially, I'm going to import this module for that. I have to write the command import pandas, okay? And you can keep it as like import pandas. Once pandas is imported, you can use this panda for data manipulation, data analysis, okay? So I just want a short name for this pandas. For that, you can say as PD, whatever you want. I've just named it as PD, right? So let me run this again. So basically panda provide us the data representation in a tabular format that is known as data frame. Okay, so how this data frame look like? It has some horizontal entries, these are known as rows, and has some vertical data that are known as columns. Okay, so basically this gray column is the first column, which is known as index column, and this first row is basically the row which contains the labels or name of that particular column. Okay, so this is how the data is being represented in a tabular format, and this data tabular representation is known as data frame. So let's begin with an example. Suppose I want to store some passengers data of the Titanic. So for the number of passengers, so I know their name, I know their age and their gender. So for a name, obviously our string data type, we can say characters data type, or it's also known as object. So an age is basically integer data type, and gender again is a character data type. It can be either male or female. Okay, so I'm just initially creating a dictionary. Okay, so for that I have named it as dictionary, and we know that dictionary stores data inside curly bracket. So inside curly bracket we place the data in key value pair. There must be a key, colon, there must be a value. Okay, that could be possible ki key is in a string, and that could be possible it can be an integer. So in my case, because I have three different data of my three data representation of my passenger, like their name, their age and their sex, their gender. So these all three data are basically strings, so I will keep it as like a string. So string can be put inside single quotes or it can be put inside double quotes. So right now the very first key is name, and there will be a list of passengers, so I will pass inside square bracket. We know that list are being passed inside square bracket. Another key value pair is age, all right and then list of age separate by comma, and the third key value pair is basically gender and colon, their values again list. Suppose the very first passenger is Muhammad Ahmed, and another passenger is suppose Anam, and the third passenger is Mosfera. Okay, these are three passengers, and each passenger's respective age will be stored inside this list. Suppose 23 and then 20 and then 19. Okay, and their genders male, and the second passenger is basically female, and third passenger is also female. So once I created this dictionary, I just want to show you the data of this dictionary. Okay, so as you can see over here, I'm done with dictionary and I have three different passengers data, like their name, their age and their gender. Now I just want to convert this dictionary into data frame, means that into this tabular format, okay, containing entries as rows and then some columns. I want this data representation in a tabular format, okay? So let me convert this dictionary into data frame, and let me tell you that Panda provide us this facility that we can convert any list to any CSV file, Excel file, or any dictionary or list into a data frame. For that, I have just created a variable df inside which I'm going to store my whole data frame. There is a function inside Panda that is data frame, so I have used this function of this pandas, alright, and to boom, I'm trying to convert into data frame. I want to convert this dictionary into data frame. So what Panda is going to do is just apply this data frame function on this dictionary and convert it into data frame and assign it to this df, right? So let me print this df. Let's run this df. Now you can see over here, initially the data was stored like a dictionary and I have just converted into tabular format. Have you observed that they have just put the column name? These column name are automatically decided by this function data frame. It take name as first column and age as second column and gender as third column. It is being decided as per the order given inside my dictionary, okay? And you can see over here there's an index column, and that is being by default it provides this index column. If I want to change it, I can even change this index column. It's up to me. We will do it later. For now, you just know how to create a dictionary and how you have converted that particular dictionary into a data frame. So alright, this was all about data frame. But inside data frame, if you are accessing a particular column, that particular column is known as series. Alright, so I'm just interested in working with the data in the column age. As I told you, this is the data frame. Inside this data frame, I'm just interested in this age column. I want to access this age column. For that, I will use this square bracket. Inside that, in single quotes, I will name this column. It's because age, so I will pass age. Okay, so it just give me the data of this age column. Okay, so basically how the data is represented over here, it is telling me the name of column and data type. Its data type is integer. At entry 0, the age is 23. At entry 1, these are basically index number. Okay, at entry 1, age is 20, and at entry second entry, the age is 19. So this, when I access only a single column, it is known as series. Okay, so if I want to create a series from scratch myself, this is how I have just extracted this particular column from my data frame. Okay, so this particular column be extracted from that data frame and it is known as series. But what if I just want to create it from scratch? So for that, excuse me, for that, suppose I've created a variable ages and as series, okay, and then I said I create the series of these values, like we have 23, 20, 23, 20, and 19, and name is age. Okay, so this is how I have created series. So excuse me. So these are the results, and this is how I have created a series from very scratch, as pandas provide us a function data frame for converting particular data into data frame. Similarly, I've just converted this list and I named this list as a age. Okay, and similarly as data frame, I've just converted this list into series. So This is how you can create series from scratch. Okay, so pandas series has no column labels as it is just a single column of a data frame, so series does not have any row labels as well. Okay, so let's do something with data frame or series. I just want to know the maximum age of the passenger, who is the eldest one, suppose. Okay, so for that I just say get data frame age column dot max. I just apply this max function, so it just return me the eldest one person's age, I mean the max age. That max age is 23. As you can see over here, we have 23, 20 and 19. Or among all these three, 23 is the max value, so it just return me this max value. So we can do this by selecting the age column and apply max function. So this is how I apply the max function, and the same thing can be applied on series. What was the name of series? Age series. So dot max excuse me, so it returned me max value. All right, so as illustrated by max method, you can do things like that with data frame or series, as I did max. Okay, you can also find min, you can also find median, and you can even find mean. It's up to you what you want to calculate. You can apply these built-in functions on these data frame and series. Okay, so since these are functions, you have to place these parentheses, right? So suppose I'm interested in some basic statistics of numerical data of my data table. So right now, if you can see over here, this data frame or data table contains some, you know, string column, or we can say object column, and it also contains integer column as well. So I'm just interested in this numerical data because we know that statistics can be calculated of these numerical values. That is why I'm just trying to calculate all the states of this numeric column. Okay. For that, we actually have a built-in function. That method or that function is describe. Df dot describe and then round bracket. Just because it's a method, and again I have to use these parentheses. Let's run this. Here's the magic. It just give me the count. There are total three values, so it give me count 3, and it calculated the mean 23, 20, and 19. Among these three values, it calculated mean and returned me mean. Standard deviation, minimum and percentile, at, you know, 25th percentile and 50th and 75. That's basically, you know, lower, upper and middle percentile. And this is the maximum value and this one is the minimum value. Right, so have you observed that this describe method basically give us a quick overview of numerical data and data frame? It has an all numerical data are 3 basically, and its mean is this, standard deviation is this, the minimum values are these, and the max values are these. So basically it give me overall overview of my numerical data set. So is name and gender columns are textual data, or we can say they are, you know, object data. So these are by default not taken into account by the describe method. It's automatically or by default just take all the columns which are of numeric data type. I hope it is enough clear. So these are the few things that you have to remember. The first is that you have, before using pandas, you have to import that package, and if you want to name it as pd, so don't forget to do that. And other thing is that a table of data is stored as a pandas data frame. Each column in data frame is a series, and you can do things by applying a method to the data frame or even series. That's all for today. Thank you.